Hey guys, today we are reviewing this Scorpion XO GT 930 modular helmet. It is what I believe to be the best modular helmet on the market right now. We're going to talk about the features and then I'm going to explain to you why I feel it's the best helmet and why it is definitely the best helmet for me. My absolute favorite feature of this transforming Bluetooth helmet is the fact that you can convert it from a full face helmet to an open face helmet. And I don't mean just lifting the chin guard up like that, but watch. Put your thumbs in here on the side. There's little notches right there, see that? Push down, pull forward. It's already released, and voila, we have a 3/4 helmet. Removable chin guard. This may not look very attractive like this, but there's a fix for that. And they have a lock here, so you can also lock that visor up if you have the chin guard up. Here is your top vents. There's also a vent here in the face shield. I know some people aren't gonna like that look right there. So, sun peek. Gives you a little shade while you're riding. Cleans this look all up. Looks great, right? Awesome. The thumb holes are right there again. Push down. Pull forward, comes right off. So another feature is this slide right here. Watch what happens when I slide this back. We have this sunshade that pops down, slide it forward, rolls back up into the helmet. Now that is really nice if you're somebody who has to wear prescription glasses. Maybe you don't have those lenses that become shaded and tinted when the sun comes out. So if you're riding on an overcast day, and the sun comes out, rather than having to stop and change your glasses, simply do that and you have sunshade. Do that and it goes back. I was actually impressed with the venting in this helmet. I can feel the difference when I turn these vents on and off. So you close it like that, slide it back to open it, lets air flow through here, comes out this exhaust port on the back of the helmet. The helmet has great lines. It's a little dirty. I've worn this thing a lot of miles. We'll talk about that in a minute. It also has a really nice vent here in the front. Open and close that. Like I said, I can really feel a difference when I have the vents open on this. I've had other helmets with vents and I couldn't tell if they were open and closed. I can actually feel that airflow through this helmet. They've done a really nice job with the venting on it. This has an advanced polycarbonate shell with dual density EPS. As I recall, when I was looking at it for ordering my size, they have 3 different shell sizes, has a completely removable inner lining, so you can take this out and wash it. Now, I don't want to take it loose right now because I have my Bluetooth comm unit ran through there and cabling up in there and stuff, but it is very nice. We get a double D-ring construction for the chin strap with really nice padding on the face side of the chin strap. Also have that little button that you can tuck it up in there and clip it so that the strap's not flapping around and hitting you. I prefer these types of D-ring buckles over the ratcheting ones. That's just a personal preference for me. This helmet does meet DOT requirements for those of us in the US. And if anybody in Europe cares, it is approved for ECE P/J. Now I gotta say, this inner lining in here, if you can see my hands pushing on this, is really comfortable all the way around. Cheek pads, nice and plush. We have nice big pockets back here that I have my Cardo speakers in. We'll talk more about that in a second and why I'm doing that. It's got this little groove here that's supposed to make room for your sunglasses. I have to say this is probably the most comfortable helmet I have worn in 20 years. I am really, really impressed with it. Not only does it have a removable, washable inner lining, but it comes with a chin skirt. And I think that is really nice. That really helps with the wind noise and stuff. I find a lot of helmets do not come with that or you have to pay extra for it. Now this came with the clear shield. I upgrade to a smoked shield. Show you how easy this is to put back together. We're done. Now if you want to lock this helmet up in place, you can put it up, slide this red lock back here, and now it can't come down. This particular smoked visor I got has a pin lock system. Unfortunately, the pin lock is on back order still, but I really like this visor. Everything seals really well. This has got to be one of the quietest helmets I've had in 30 years. Now let's talk about the Bluetooth, because they advertise this as a Bluetooth helmet. So there's actually a little lid that goes here, and they have a Bluetooth unit called the ExoCom that's made by Uclear, or powered by Uclear, that goes in here. Now, I took this hatch off so I could get my Cardo wiring through here to put my mic and my speakers on the inside. I run a Cardo because I already had Cardos when I got this helmet, and my girlfriend has a Cardo so that we can talk. Now, my Cardo speakers fit recessed in this lining of the helmet. Works great. I don't have any pressure on my ears from the speakers, but yet I can hear them. Try and get you a peek at the speaker pods in here. You can see right there, there's a hole cut into the shell. The speakers set recessed in that behind this lining. Back here, I have put some of my extra cabling in here, but that is actually a battery compartment for the ExoCom. So this thing integrates in very nicely if you get it with the ExoCom. Now, if you purchase this helmet without the ExoCom, it is $250. I think that is a great value for a helmet like this with all of these features. With the ExoCom, it runs about $425. I want to be 100% transparent. Scorpion did send me this as a sample to review it. That was last fall. I got it just as the weather was cooling down. I have not done a review. They have not asked me about it or when I was going to do it. No pressure whatsoever for me to say or do anything with this helmet. I just told them I wanted it. I was actually looking at buying it. I talked to them in person at a rally and I tried it on to see how it fits. And so I knew what size was the right size for me. I'm actually wearing a medium in this. I really like the way it fits. One of the nice things about it being a modular helmet and having this open face is when I go to put it on, I can flex it a little bit. It makes it a little easier to get that on, especially if you have glasses or something. And then you can ratchet it all down and it fits nice and tight and snug. I have not done the review until now because it's now late July and we have temperatures up in the 90s multiple days. I've got to test and ride this helmet when it was very, very warm. I didn't want to do this review until I knew how this helmet performed in the really warm parts of the summer here in the Ozarks when it gets really hot. Many days were near the triple digits, and we even have a few days in the triple digits here in the dead of summer. Now, before I give you my final kind of thoughts and my personal opinions of this helmet, it's important for you to understand where I come from. Let me show you the helmet I wore for almost 20 years. This is commonly called a skid lid or a novelty helmet. Now, I live in a state that just recently modified their helmet law. Up until 3 or 4 years ago, we had a mandatory helmet law. You were supposed to wear a DOT-approved helmet. I wore this DOT-approved helmet that's not really DOT-approved. But the fact is, where I lived, nobody in 20 years ever checked my helmet, ever harassed me about a helmet, never cared. The law was not enforced. The only time people got helmet tickets here were when they were being idiots, excessive speeding, or doing burnouts or things like that, and then they'd get a helmet ticket on top of that if they didn't have a proper DOT helmet. But if you were just riding sensibly, I never saw anyone get harassed about having a DOT helmet. But obviously, if I wore this for 20 years, safety isn't my number one concern. Now, I'm glad to know this helmet is very safe. And as I get older, I become more concerned with that. Maybe it has to do with the fact that my girlfriend had a motorcycle accident a few years ago. She was wearing a 3/4 helmet. She went off of the motorcycle, was, you know, thrown from it. She didn't have any severe injuries. And, you know, I'm glad she was wearing a helmet. And because of that, I have been trying to wear a helmet more frequently. There are days that I still don't wear a helmet, but I wear this helmet much, much more frequently than any other DOT helmet I've had in 30 years because of these features. But the fact that I can have a full face helmet when it's raining and storming and having those protection from the elements. But if the weather gets nice, the sun comes out, And I don't want a full face helmet. I can put it in the upright position. I can ride down the highway with it like this. I've ran at interstate speeds with it up like that, and it was not bad. But if you get somewhere and you want to take that off, it's really simple. That quick, throw it in a bag so you don't scratch up your shield. Slap your Sun Peak on, just like that, and you're ready to go. Now, how fast is that? How nice is that? That's how it works every time. It's that simple. Now, I know someone's gonna comment that a modular helmet is not as safe as a regular full face helmet. I've heard stories about the chin bar breaking in an accident, things like that. And I won't argue those things. They may be true, but I will tell you something else is true. Wearing a modular helmet is better than wearing no helmet at all or wearing the skid lid. So, you know, if you love full face helmets, that's great. If you're someone like me that's struggling to wear a helmet, that you keep wanting to ride without a helmet or revert to something like the skid lid, this is something that you might be able to live with because of the comfort factors and the features of it and still have better protection than riding without a helmet at all. All right, guys. Well, that is why I think this is the absolute best modular helmet on the market right now. And really, it boils down to the fact that it's comfortable, it's quiet, it's got great features, it's affordable, and, you know, I just can't show you guys enough how easy this is. Thumbs on each side, get them in the right spot, pull forward, put your thumb on the inside and pull, and there you go, it's off. So, anyway, thanks for your time. Hope you guys have a great day. Be safe, keep on riding, and we'll see you in the next one.